Let's discuss the exercise problems of chapter 9. So question number first, an object experiences a net zero external unbalanced force. Is it possible for the object to be traveling with a non-zero velocity? If yes, state the conditions that must be placed on the magnitude and direction of the velocity. If no, provide a reason. So obviously it is yes, because when there is no net force on the body, so if the body is moving, so it will keep on moving according to Newton's laws of motion. So if a body is moving, so it will keep on moving until and unless some external force is applied on it. So to change the state of motion of that moving body, a net non-zero external force must be applied on the object. So let's move on to next question. So next question is, when a carpet is beaten with a stick, dust comes out of it. Explain. So yes, when a carpet is beaten with a stick, initially both carpet and dust particles are at rest. But suddenly when the carpet is beaten, so the carpet starts moving from its place, but the dust particles are still in a state of motion due to its inertia, in a state of rest due to its inertia. So because of that, dust particles come out of it. So this is due to Newton's first law of motion. So let's move on to next question. Why is it advised to tie any luggage kept on the roof of the bus with a rope? So similarly, this is again by Newton's first law of motion. When the bus is at rest, the luggage is also at rest, but when the bus starts moving, so luggage is still, due to its inertia, luggage still tends to be at rest. So due to which some jerk is experienced by the luggage, so the luggage tends to remain at its original position and ultimately falls from the roof of the bus. To avoid this, it is advised to tie any luggage kept on the roof of the bus with a rope. So next question. A batsman hits a cricket ball which then roll on the level ground. So when a ball is hitted, when the ball starts rolling on the ground, there is some force acting on the ball which tends to stop the motion of the ball. So that force is called frictional force of the ground. So when the ball starts rolling on the ground, frictional force on the ball from the ground starts opposing its motion. So the ball slows down to a stop. So option C is correct. So next question, a truck starts, this is a numerical. So a truck starts from rest and rolls down a hill with a constant acceleration. So it starts from a rest, So that means initial velocity is zero. So it travels a distance of 400 meters. So S is equal to 400 meters. In t time is equal to 20 seconds. So find its acceleration. So first we have to find out the acceleration. So we all know that S is equal to ut plus half at square. So S is 400, u is 0, t is 20 seconds plus half at is 20 seconds. So 20 square. So this will be 0, 0 multiply any number is 0. So taking 2 here, it is 800 divided by 20 multiplied 20 is 400 is equal to A. So this implies acceleration is equal to 2 meter per second square. So this is acceleration. Next part of it, find the force acting on it if the mass is 7 metric tons. 7 metric tons. So in 1 metric ton, we have 1000 kg. So in 7 metric ton, we have 7 into 1000, which is 7000 kg. So we all know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. F is equal to ma. So mass is 7000. Acceleration is 2. So which is 14000 newton. Force is equal to 14000 newton. So this is the answer. So next question. A stone of 1 kg is thrown with a velocity of 20 meter per second. So initial velocity is 20 meter per second across the frozen surface of the lake and comes to rest after traveling a distance of 50 meter. So it travels a distance of 50 meter. So S is equal to 50 meter. Mass of the stone is 1 kg. What is the force of friction between the stone and the ice? So friction force we have to determine. So F is equal to, we all know that for every action there is equal and opposite reaction. So the force acting on the ball, so some force will obviously be acting in the opposite direction. So that force is frictional force. So frictional force is equal to F is equal to ma. So a we have to determine for it. So for a we all know that v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So finally the ball, finally the stone comes to rest. So v is equal to 0. So 0 initial velocity is 0 square, initial velocity is 20 square plus 2a. A we have to determine s is 50. So this implies 0 is equal to 400 plus 100a. So this implies a is equal to minus 4 meter per second square. So acceleration is minus 4 meter per second square. Now from Newton's second law of motion, we can say force is equal to F is equal to ma. So mass into acceleration. So mass of the stone is 1 kg. Acceleration is minus 4. So this is force is equal to minus 4 Newton. Why it is of negative sign? Because this is frictional force. So frictional force from the ice is, frictional force between the stone and the ice is F is equal to minus 4 Newton. This is the answer. So let's move on to next question. 7. And a 8000 kg engine pulls a train of 5 wagons. So M mass of the engine is 8000 kg and the mass of the wagons is 2000 kgs. So there are 5 wagons. If the engine exerts a force of 40,000 Newton, so F is equal to 40,000 Newton, and the track offers a friction of force, frictional force of 5,000 Newton, then calculate the net accelerating force. So net accelerating force will be F net will be equal to force minus force of friction, because if this is, suppose this is a train, so or this is an object, so it is moving in this direction, so frictional force will act in this direction. So if still the object keeps its motion up, if the object starts moving, that means it is overcoming this frictional force. So this is frictional force, this is force which is acting on it. So net force will be F minus Fs. So F is 40,000 minus Fs is 5,000. So this is 35,000 Newton. You can take it with plus sign here also. So 35,000 Newton is the force which is acting in totality on the engine. So accelerating, second part, acceleration of the train. So now we have to find out acceleration. So we all know F is equal to ma. So m here will be let's write it down as ma. So m here will be net mass. So net mass is 8000 plus there are 5 wagons, so 5 multiplied by 2000, so this is net mass, total mass multiplied by acceleration we have to determine, and force value is 35,000 we have already determined, so is equal to 8, 5 multiplied by 2 is 10, 18,000 a. So this implies a is equal to 35,000 divided by 18,000. So 35,000 divided by 18,000 will be how much? This will be 1.944 meter per second square. So 1.944 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration of the train. So next part, an automobile vehicle has a mass of 1500 kg. What must be the force between the vehicle and the road if the vehicle is to be stopped with a negative acceleration of 1.7 meter per second square? So mass is 1500 kg, a is 1.7 meter per second square. So F is equal to ma, mass into acceleration. So 1500 multiplied by minus of 1.7. So this will be minus of 2550 Newton. So force is equal to minus of 2550 Newton. So we have to first determine what are the things given to us. Once we'll get to know about those things, and then it will be very easy for us to solve the numerical. So next, ninth question. What is the momentum of an object of mass m moving with a velocity v? We all know that momentum is equal to mass into velocity. So option D is correct. Next, 10th question. Using the horizontal force of 200 Newton, we intend to move a wooden cabinet across the floor at a constant velocity. So what is the friction force that will be exerted on the cabinet? So the friction force will be equal to, you know, from Newton's third law of motion, an equal amount of force will act in the opposite direction. For every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So F, the friction force will also be of 200 Newton. So this is the answer. Next, two objects each of mass 1.5 kg are moving in the same straight line but in opposite direction. So if there are two objects, so one object is this one, other object is this one, moving in a same straight line but in opposite direction. So this is M1, M2. This is V1, U1, initial velocity U2. So U1 is 2.5 meter per second square per second, and U2 in opposite direction. So we have taken with minus sign. So minus of 2.5 meter per second square. So before the collision, during the which they stick together, what will be the velocity of the combined object after collision? So after the collision, they will move together. So they will move together. So let both of them velocity will be V. V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V. So according to law of conservation of momentum, we can say M1 U1 plus M2 U2. You have to write down here according to law of conservation of momentum is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. So V1 is equal to V2. So M value is 1.5 bracket 2.5 plus 1.5 bracket minus 2.5. is equal to M1 1.5 plus M2 1.5. V1 is equal to V2, so V have taken out. So this will be 1.5 multiplied 2.5 is 3.75. So 3.75 minus 3.75 is equal to 3V. So this will be 0 is equal to 3V. So V is equal to 0 upon 3, which is 0. So velocity, final velocity of both the combined object of both combined object after the collision will be 0 meter per second. So this is the answer. So let's move on to next 12th question. So 12th question, according to third law of motion, when we push on an object, the object pushes back on us with an equal and opposite force. So if the object is a massive truck parked along the roadside, it will probably not move. A student justifies this by answering that the two opposite and equal forces cancel each other. Comment on this logic and explain why the truck does not move. So we all know that the mass of the truck is very large. So therefore the static friction between the truck and the road is also very high. So to move the truck, one has to apply a force more than the static friction. So therefore, when someone pushes the truck and the truck does not move, then it can be said that the applied force in one direction is cancelled out by the frictional force of equal amount acting in the opposite direction. So since, you know, whenever an object is kept at rest, so there will be some static friction acting on that object, which, you know, we have to apply force greater than that static friction in order to move that object. So therefore, it can be said that the applied force in one direction is cancelled out by the frictional force of equal amount acting on in the opposite direction if the object is not moving. The next question, a hockey ball of mass 200 gram, so M is equal to 200 gram, which is 0.2 kg, is travelling with the initial velocity of 10 meter per second. So let the initial velocity be 10 meter per second. So is struck by a hockey stick so as to return it along the same original path with a velocity of 5 meter per second. So let's take U with negative sign. So rightward direction we are taking negative and leftward direction we are taking positive. So V is equal to plus 5. Now change in momentum is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. So MV minus MU. So M we have taken out 0.2. V minus U, 5 minus minus 10. So this will be minus minus plus. So 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 multiplied by 0.2 is 3 kg. meter per second. So change in momentum will be 3 kg meter per second. Let's move on to next question, question number 14. A bullet of mass 10 gram traveling horizontally with a velocity of 150 meter per second. So it is traveling horizontally with a velocity of 150 meter per second. So u is 150 meter per second. M is 10 gram, so which is 0.01 kg. So comes to and rest after 0.03 seconds. So t is equal to 0.03 seconds, and it comes to rest. That means v is equal to zero. So s we have to determine. Calculate the distance of the penetration of the bullet. Also calculate the magnitude of force exerted by the wooden block on the bullet. So f also we have to determine. So firstly we have to determine final velocity. So we all know that v is equal to u plus at. So v is equal to u plus at. So v we have to determine. U is 150 plus v is given, it is 0. So 150 plus a we have to determine, t is 0.03. so final velocity is 0, 150 plus 0.03 a. So a will be equal to minus 150 upon 0.03. so one minus 150 upon 0.03 will be minus of 5000 meter per second square. So this is a. So a we have determined. Now we have to determine s. So v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So v is 0, u is 150 square, plus 2a is minus 5000 s. So from here we'll get s is equal to 2.25 meter. So if s is 2.25 meter, now f is equal to ma. So f, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So mass is 0.01, acceleration is 5000. So 5000, so this will be 50 newton. So 50 newton. So a magnitude of force exerted by the wooden block on the bullet. So this force will be, if we take acceleration with negative sign, so that means the force exerted by the bullet on the wooden block will be of 50, minus 50 newton. So wooden block exerts a force of 50 newton on the bullet. So this is the answer. So next, question number 15th. So question number 15th is, an object of mass 1 kg traveling with a velocity of 10 meter per second. So m1 is equal to 1 kg, u1 is 10 meter per second, collides with and sticks to a stationary wooden block of mass 5 kg. So m2 is 5 kg. Stationary wooden block means u2 is 0 meter per second. So sticks to a wooden stationary wooden block, that means v1 is equal to v2 is equal to v. So this we have assumed. So now then they both move off together in the same straight line. Calculate the total momentum just before the impact and just after the impact, and calculate the combined velocity. So momentum before impact is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. So m1 is 1, u1 is 10, m2 is 5, u2 is 0. So this will be 10 kg meter per second. So momentum after collision is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So m1 is again 1, v1 is v, plus m2 is 5, v2 is v. So this will be 5 plus 1, 6 v. Final momentum. So we all know that initial momentum will be equal to final momentum according to law of conservation of momentum. So according to law of conservation of momentum, m1 u1 plus m2 u2, you have to write down according to law of conservation of momentum, is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So this implies 10 is equal to 6v, or we can say v is equal to, this implies v is equal to 5 by 3 meter per second. So v is 5 by 3 meter per second. So total momentum just after impact will be 6v. So momentum after impact, is equal to 6v. So 6 bracket 5 upon 3. So
3 multiplied 2 is 6, 5 multiplied 2 is 10 kg meter per second. So we can say initial momentum is equal to final momentum. So let's move on to next question, question number 16. An object of mass 100 kg, so m is equal to 100 kg, is moving uniformly from a velocity, is accelerated uniformly from a velocity of 5 meter per second to 8 meter per second. So u is 5 meter per second, v is 8 meter per second, time is 6 seconds. Calculate the initial and final momentum. So initial momentum will be equal to, momentum is equal to mu. So m is 100, u is 5. So this will be 500 kg meter per second. So final momentum is equal to mv, so 100, v is 8, so this will be 800 kg meter per second. Now we have to find out the force. So we all know that force exerted on the object, so f will be equal to change in momentum, rate of change of momentum, so mv minus mu upon t. So mv is 800 minus 500 upon t, t is 6, 300 upon 6, it is 50 newton. So 50 newton is the answer. So let's move on to next question. Akhtar, Karan, Rahul were riding in a motor car with a high velocity on an expressway when an insect hit the windshield and got stuck on the windscreen. Akhtar and Kiran started pondering over the situation. So Kiran suggested that the insect suffered a greater change in momentum as compared to the change in momentum of the car. Akhtar said that since the motor car was moving with a large velocity, it exerted a large force on the insect. As a result, the insect died. Rahul, while putting an entirely new explanation, said that both the motor car and the insect experienced the same force and a change in their momentum. Comment on their suggestions. So we all know that Rahul, what Kiran said, since the momentum of the car and the insect system before collision is equal to momentum of car and insect just after the collision, according to law of conservation of momentum. So hence the change of momentum of the car and the insect system will be zero. So the insect gets stuck on the windscreen. This means that the direction of the insect is reversed. So as a result, the velocity of the insect changes to a great amount. So on the other hand, the car continues moving with a constant velocity. Hence, Kiran's suggestion that the insect suffers a greater change in momentum as compared to the car is correct. So the momentum of the insect after the collision becomes very high because the car is moving at a high speed. So therefore, the momentum gained by the insect is equal to the momentum lost by the car. So Akhtar made a correct conclusion because the mass of the car is very large as compared to the mass of the insect. So let's come to Rahul. So Rahul is partially correct as both the car and insect experience equal forces caused by third law of motion. But the momentum before collision is equal to the momentum after collision. So there will be no change in their momentum. Next question, how much momentum will a dumbbell of mass 10 kg transfer to the floor if it falls from a height of 80 cm? So acceleration is 10 meter per second. So mass is 10 kg, s is 80 cm, that means 0.8 meter. So we have to find out how much momentum. So momentum, change in momentum we have to find out. Final momentum we have to determine. So let's find out. Change in momentum we have to determine. So initial momentum, since u is equal to 0 meter per second, so initial momentum will be equal to mu. So m is 10, u is 0, so this is 0 kg meter per second. So final momentum is equal to mv. For that we have to determine v. So v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So v square is equal to 0 square plus 2a is 10, s is 0.8. So v square is equal to this will be 8 multiplied by 2 is 16, so 16. So this implies v is equal to 4 meter per second. So since v is 4 meter per second, so final momentum will be is equal to mv. So mass is 10 multiplied v is 4, so 40 kg meter per second. So change in momentum is momentum is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum, which is 40 minus 0, which is 40 kg meter per second. So this is our answer, 40. So here we end this exercise. So thank you all.